name is Jake Sawtell. You know how they say that Christmas is the most wonderful time of the year? Well, I never believed it. That is not until last Christmas. Nothing prepared me for the changes that began only a year ago. For a while after my dad passed away, it was my mom and me. And I was thinking I'd never meet a dad again. That was until Nick came to our lives. Nick's cool, and not to get too icky, but they fell in love on Christmas Day. He asked Mom to marry him. She said yes, but something else happened on Christmas Day, too. That was the day Nick became Santa Claus. You see, Nick's dad had been Santa Claus, and it was time for him to retire. So, on Christmas morning, Nick took over the job. Mom and me, we thought that was great. You see, Santa Claus and Mrs. Claus work as a team. They spend the whole year getting ready for Christmas. And here's the problem. If you're not a Claus or an elf, you can't go to the North Pole, which means Mom and me couldn't go until they're married, which meant Nick had to do it all himself, which meant he was working day and night, which meant he didn't have time to get married. Every time Nick and Mom made plans to set a date, they had to postpone. Now it's 11 days until Christmas. Mom still doesn't know if they're gonna be able to get married in time for us all to have a family Christmas at the North Pole.
Merry Christmas! And to all a good night! Ernest! Oh, I'm not very convincing as a Santa. I've seen better Santas in department stores.
It takes time, sir. You'll grow into it.
Like I'll grow into my stomach?
That is true. But you'll settle in soon enough. And hopefully, you'll be as fine a Santa as this family has ever produced.
Oh, thanks, Ernest. You're such a great pal.
Oh, sir, Santa, you need to sign this.
Ernest, I've been asking you all year. Please, call me Nick.
Yes, sir. Santa. Nicholas. And this.
I promise, Jake.
And this.
What? Haven't I signed this one before?
No. That was the nice daycare center list. This is the nice preschooler list.
There's one for every grade?
In every country.
Look, that's it. I've got to go. I promised Jake I'd go to his Christmas festival.
Fine. You will tell Beth what I said about the wedding.
Which was?
Nicholas.
I'm just kidding, Ernest.
Did you sign off on the new fireproof hat?
I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up a sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. And what, to my wondering eyes, should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and he shouted and called them by name.
On Dasher, on Dancer, on Prancer, on Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen. Up to the porch, up to the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too.
Did you talk to Ernest? What did he say? Did he say we could do it?
Do you really want to get married?
Yes, stop it! What did he say?
He said yes, on Christmas Eve in the morning.
Hey, sir, we don't have to postpone it again?
Absolutely. He's got a team of elves all ready to do my final checks, and then I'm free to get married.
A Christmas Eve wedding? We are going to have a family Christmas at North Pole.
I'm still going to have a dad for Christmas.
Oh, I love you so much.
I love you too.
Yes.
In 11 days, we're actually going to be married.
All right.
Yes, that's right, 12 people. It's a small family wedding. The date? Christmas Eve? Hello? Hello?
Is two!
Is not!
Is two times infinity!
Is not times million, zillion, zillion, trillion, zillion infinity!
That's so lame!
What are you two arguing about?
Nick says the reindeer's called Donder with a D. I say it's called Donner.
Well, you should know better than to argue with Santa Claus about reindeer. Go wash your hands.
How are the wedding plans coming?
Nothing. Not a zip. No minister, no caterers, no flowers. If you wanted a Christmas Eve wedding, you should have booked in June.
How about a few days earlier?
Not if we want it the way we planned it.
Don't tell me we're gonna have to postpone the wedding again.
Oh, no, no, no.
But Beth, we want it to be perfect. I'm really sorry, honey. We should have done this months ago.
Oh, no, it's nobody's fault. We couldn't get married because you're working all hours of the day and night. And you're working all hours of the day and night because we couldn't get married. If that's not a catch-22, I don't know what is. If they just could have let me go to the North Pole to help you before we got married, we would be married by now.
Woulda, coulda, shoulda. Nobody goes to the North Pole unless you're a Claus or an elf.
Don't I know it?
You know what we could do? We could put off selling the house and have our family Christmas here. Get married after the holidays.
That'll be Ernest.
Where is he?
Ernie!
The elves in the meteorological department need a meeting with you about the route we'll be taking, and the veterinary department needs to talk to you about Rudolph's nose.
What's wrong with Rudolph's nose?
Low glow. And packaging says you still haven't signed off on the revised naughty list. Yes, that's the one your father and your grandfather didn't like either. But if you can't stand the heat...
Hi, Ernest. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Ben. Ernest, if we decide to postpone the wedding again, what day in January is good?
If you what?
We may have to postpone the wedding again.
You cannot postpone the wedding again.
Why not?
You have to get married. You can't have Christmas without a Mrs. Claus.
But you told him he could last year when you thought I wasn't going to marry him.
There doesn't have to be one if I know there isn't going to be one. Then I can go to Plan B.
Well, now you know. Go to Plan B.
I don't have a Plan B because I knew Plan A was going to work. I knew by hook or by crook we'd find the time finally to get you two together. And that there'd be a Mrs. Claus.
But there isn't going to be a Mrs. Claus, so make a Plan B.
It's too late. I can't put a Plan B together from scratch in 11 days.
And I can't put together a wedding from scratch in 11 days.
We cannot postpone the wedding again. You have to get married. There has to be a Mrs. Claus. Now, we're supposed to be getting ready for Christmas. Are you coming?
In a moment.
Why don't you just snap your fingers and do some sand magic and make it all happen the way you want?
I'm only allowed to do serious magic for other people. I'm not allowed to do it for myself.
It's simple. We'll ask your mother to come out of retirement for one night. Then Ernest will get his Mrs. Claus. We'll have our family Christmas here, like you said. And then we'll have the wedding in January, like we planned.
Oh, honey, that's brilliant.
We should ask her in person. We'll drive down to the desert in the morning. Are you going to be here?
I'll meet you there. I knew I wasn't marrying you just because you're so darn pretty.
Okay, you two, that's enough. Neg, tee off again, and no cheating this time.
Okay.
So funny. I'm sorry. Now, what were you saying?
Oh, well, all this year, Nick and I have been planning the perfect wedding. It's so great. We want exactly the same thing.
And that would be?
Nothing extravagant. Very small, very beautiful, very romantic. Every single piece has been handpicked.
Yes?
And that's all I'm going to tell you. You have to see the rest. I think you're going to like it.
I'm sure I will, my dear. Okay, now, what can I do to help?
Well, in order to get what we want, we're going to have to postpone it until after Christmas.
But Ernest says we can't because we have to have a Mrs. Claus this Christmas.
So we were wondering, would you come back and be Nick's Mrs. Claus this Christmas Eve?
Oh, Beth, that's the one thing I can't do. You know the rules.
But, Mom, it's just for one day, Christmas Eve.
Not even one day, and Nick, you should know that.
What would happen if there isn't a Mrs. Claus?
Nick's mom put the heart and the spirit into Christmas, just like his grandmother and his great-grandmother and all the Mrs. Clauses before her.
How would it be different?
That's just it. It won't be Christmas.
Well, that's all there is to it. We'll get a judge, we'll get married at home. It'll just be him, the three of us. At least we'll have our family Christmas at the North Pole.
You can't do that. We've been waiting all year for this.
We've been waiting our whole life. This is the start of our married life.
You have to do it right.
Even if it were possible. I've got so much on my plate. I gotta sell this house. I gotta pack up. I gotta move out. I've gotta finish everything up at work. I've gotta get all Jake's school stuff ready to take there and show to the teachers at the North Pole. I can't believe I just said that.
What about a wedding planner?
A wedding? We don't want a cookie-cutter wedding. Besides, do you know one? One that's available 10 days before Christmas? Can Ernest do it?
Ernest? Ernest does not have much spare time right now.
Grandmother can do it. You always see that she has the whole town organized exactly the way she wants it.
Yeah, that wasn't a compliment.
Is she a good organizer?
Yes. No. I mean, yes. She can organize the whole Macy's Day Parade quicker than you can pick out what color socks to wear.
He always wears red socks.
Exactly. No, no way, no how.
Would you rather have a rent-a-judge?
Yes.
No, I don't know. She's not going to do it the way we plan.
It can be small and beautiful, just the way you want it. It'll give you a chance to work together and get closer again.
We never were close.
Well, perhaps if you give her a call, maybe, and tell her exactly what we want, she'll listen.
No way.
Beth, do we have a choice?
Yes, Mother. Thank you, Mother. Are you sure you understand what we want?
Well, you want a small romantic wedding, strictly family and friends.
You haven't visited me for 2 years. Would you like to have it at my house? Would you like my housekeeper to cater it for you? And you want to get married in less than 10 days?
On the morning of Christmas Eve, is that right?
That's right, Mother.
And you want me to organize it for you?
I'd like to do it together.
And I'd like to do it together. I'll be there as soon as...
And you'll be bringing your fiancé,
what's his name? Nicholas, with you?
It's Nick. I'll try, but he's very busy with his work.
Elizabeth, it would be nice to meet my future son-in-law before he is my son-in-law.
When will you be here?
As soon as I get the house packed up.
Well, no, I knew that will take at least a week, so I'll get started without you.
Although I don't understand why you can't wait until the new year to do this properly.
You're not?
Oh, no, I am not.
Oh, well, that's a relief.
All right, then.
It's settled.
Thanks, Mom.
So she'll do it?
Yes.
You still haven't told her who I am, have you?
It's not the kind of thing you tell people on the phone, especially her. I was going to tell her as soon as she got here.
So you'll tell her when you get there? At least Ernest can breathe a lot easier now.
Well, I'm glad he can.
You got it, Jay.
In a minute, you'll be gone. I still can't believe it.
Me either.
I wish I could come to your mother's.
Oh, so do I.
I mean, you know I would. It just it being Christmas and so spur of the moment.
I told you I understand.
In 5 days, you will be Mrs. Claus and living at the North Pole.
Shh. What an adventure. It'll be an adventure, all right.
All right, what's wrong?
Well, you know me, Joni. I'm not big on adventures. When Jake and I go on vacation, I'm the one that likes to sit on the beach with a good book, remember?
So what are you saying?
I don't know what I'm saying. I find it hard to mother just Jake. How am I supposed to be Mrs. Claus?
Well, Nick will help you.
No, I think I'm supposed to help him. I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Hey. All right. You have pre-wedding jitters. That's what you've got. Every bride gets them. You'd be crazy not to. You'll do fine.
You're right.
Hey, Mom and Dad, you got here! Hey, Mom. Hey, Dad.
You all done?
Yep. They're gonna keep it in storage until after Christmas, then I'll arrange to have it all picked up.
So, young man, I understand you're coming to stay with me and Mrs. Claus for a couple of days. So Beth and Nick can go down and visit your grandmother on their own. And Nick can get to know her before we fly down and join them. You think that's a good idea?
You bet, Santa.
You know, I'm not Santa anymore. Nick is. But in 5 days, your mom is going to become my daughter-in-law. So I think that that makes me your grandpa.
So you're going to be okay for a couple days without me? I'll be with my grandpa. Hi, Grandpa.
Bye, Beth.
This is your mom's place? This is where you grew up?
After my daddy died. It was my grandparents' place. We came to live here, and after they passed on, we stayed.
I never imagined. I mean, I know you said your family was comfortable. I didn't think you meant comfortable. I thought you meant you were normal.
Normal? And this coming from a guy who's friends with elves and plays fetch with reindeer?
Yes,
but... I am normal. This place isn't me.
Beth, your life as Mrs. Claus won't be anything like this. We're much simpler. More down to earth.
If I'd wanted all this, I wouldn't have left all this, now would I?
Okay, let's go.
Get a good look at you. My, you're sad for sore eyes. You look wonderful.
Thank you.
And you must be the reason for all the commotion around here. I'm Winnie, Mrs. Hardcastle's housekeeper.
Oh! So great to meet you. Beth has told me all about you. You were her babysitter and her best friend.
Come along inside. Best we get this over with. Hello, Mother.
Oh, Elizabeth, you finally got here. I thought you'd be here hours ago.
Sorry.
You put on a little weight?
Oh, yeah, probably a pound or two. You know, the holidays and all.
Oh, your hair. How many times have I told you not to hide that pretty face?
Too many. Mother, this is Nick.
Beth's mom. Oh, hi. It's great to finally meet you. May I call you Mom?
Joanna will be just fine. Please sit down. Winnie would like some tea.
I would prefer some hot chocolate, actually.
Nick doesn't drink much tea.
Brought you this.
Oh. Oh, how nice.
It's from the North Pole.
Oh, really?
Really it is.
Nicholas, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself? What do you do?
About what?
Your job.
Nick's in distribution.
Distribution of...
different...
things?
Oh, what kinds of things?
It's very technical, Mother. It would take forever to explain.
And your parents, they're...
fine. They're just fine.
The family is so very important. I mean, we Hardcastles can trace our lineage back... oh, almost 700 years.
Nick can trace his back more than 1,000 years.
Really?
Yes, and...
we should get started.
With what?
The wedding.
Oh.
I was thinking maybe that...
Oh, no, it is all taken care of. I have put together a schedule that takes us from your arrival now through your departure on your honeymoon.
What? The schedule?
Well, we want this wedding to be a success, don't we?
Well, yes, but what
now, your parents are arriving here the day after tomorrow in the morning, and they're bringing my grandson with them. Is that correct?
That's correct, Mom. Joanna.
And the next day there will be dress fittings, and then that night there's the engagement party.
An engagement party?
It will be black tie. I assume you brought a tuxedo, Nicholas?
Yes, of course.
Then the next day there will be the rehearsal and rehearsal dinner.
Rehearsal and rehearsal dinner?
And then there is the wedding at the church on Friday, Christmas Eve, at 10:30 a.m. And you apparently have to leave for your honeymoon by... 4 p.m. Where exactly are you going?
It's a surprise for me and Jake. You have kept it small, Mother, the wedding?
Yes, Elizabeth, I kept it small. I told you I would.
Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree. La, 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 la.
Elizabeth, one more thing.
Oh, you go on up.
Joanna, I couldn't help but notice you have so few Christmas decorations.
Well, don't you think a little right is better than a lot wrong? Come along, dear.
You like Christmas?
Oh, I should say so, Winnie.
Oh, well, it's about time somebody in this house did.
What exactly do you know about the
clauses. I mean, you say they're an old family, but they're not in any of the social registers, and no one knows anything about them.
Oh, they do. They just don't know it.
What on earth do you mean by that?
They're reclusive. They do a lot of good deeds for people, but they just don't mix socially.
I just want to make sure that you're doing the right thing.
I am.
You know, Mark still asks about you after all these years.
Oh, is that the time? I better go get washed up for dinner.
Management is an hour behind because they had to wait for you to approve the new gift cards and wrapping. Now, which one of these goes best with a Barbie in a red dress? This one or this one? Or this one?
Oh. Gee, I don't know, Ernest. My father never had to deal with wrapping paper.
I know. Your mother did. Mm.
Ernest, did my father find his first Christmas this hard?
No.
He had a Mrs. Claus and he wasn't going south every 5 minutes, was he?
You ready? Nick? Are you in there?
This is Ernest.
Hi, it's Beth, Ernest. Is Nick there, please?
Yes. It's the thank goodness soon to be Mrs. Claus.
Hiya, sweetheart.
Hi, what are you doing there? Dinner's in 10 minutes.
Ooh, okay. Look, you go right on down. I'll be there in a little bit.
Being early is being on time. Being on time is late.
Got it. Bye, honey.
How did she take it?
Take what?
How did Beth's mother take it when Beth told her you were Santa Claus?
She didn't. Beth hasn't told her yet.
You know she's an unbeliever.
Ernest. Ernest. Well, Beth didn't believe also, and we turned her around, remember?
True, but there's a big difference. Beth wanted to believe, but her broken heart wouldn't let her. But Joanne is... Let's just say that Joanna isn't planning on leaving out any milk and cookies for you. Ever.
Ernest, relax. It'll take some time, but I'll turn her around. I'm Santa Claus, remember? La 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 la. Hello. Hi. Hey, oh, what a beautiful color on you. You haven't been waiting on me, have you?
We eat our meals at the o'clock, Nicholas.
Oh, I thought it was just striking. I'll be on time tomorrow. Sorry.
Winifred, you may serve dinner now.
Mother, Isn't there anything that I could do to help with the wedding? Maybe I could write out the place cards for the reception lunch.
No, they're done already.
Maybe the family dinner.
My handwriting matches the silverware better than yours. Elizabeth, you are not good at the little touches. You know that. Stop that.
Well, I'll just help Winifred prepare the food.
Do not set one foot in that kitchen. I don't want you upsetting Winifred with another one of your disasters. Besides, everything is going to turn out exactly as you wanted it. Winifred? What have you done to the tree?
I didn't do nothing to your tree.
It sure looks better. More Christmassy.
La 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 la.
Chocolate?
Of course. It's really beautiful here. Must have been an amazing place to grow up.
Why won't you let me do anything?
What am I supposed to do? Sit around here and paint my toenails all day?
She means well, honey. She just doesn't know how to show it.
You know where my room is? You know where her room is? It's an awful long walk for a little girl who just lost her daddy. Luckily, Winnie's room was right next door to mine. Do you have to go back tonight?
Yeah.
Well, Jake and me, we're gonna light the North Pole, right?
I think you will.
I'm gonna be an okay Mrs. Claus, right?
You're gonna be a great Mrs. Claus. You might be the greatest Mrs. Claus ever. Everyone thinks that being Santa's about the big stuff. Reindeer and the workshop and magic. It's not. It's about the little things. It's about the day-to-day things. It's about finding the perfect present for each child and giving it to them exactly how they want it. And Mrs. Claus, well, she helps Santa out with all that.
Show me where our home is again.
You gotta find the Big Dipper. Right. You see it?
Mm-hmm.
Now you find the brightest star. Right. That's the North Star.
Mm-hmm.
And you follow it straight down. And that's where we live.
How the old son in each generation gets to become Santa, right?
Yes, he does.
But it steps everyone get to do it.
Why not?
Well, because it's not a real son.
I'll have you know, young man, that the original Santa and Mrs. Claus back 1,000 years ago didn't have any children. So they decided that the whole world's children would be their kids. And then, when it came time, they adopted a young lad about your age to be the next Santa.
It doesn't matter that Nick isn't my real dad.
Being a dad isn't just about being related by blood. It's how you love someone. And considering how Nick loves you, I'd say you better start preparing to take over the job of Santa someday.
Really? The magic and everything?
Magic and everything.
What does it look like, Elizabeth? It's the menu for your wedding.
Poached salmon and pheasant bourguignon.
That's in red wine, remember?
I know what bourguignon is, Mother. I told you what we wanted. Simple roasted chicken.
Everyone is going to be eating far too much poultry over Christmas. No one wants to eat it on Christmas Eve. But you don't think about those little touches, do you, dear? That's why I changed it for you.
Roasted chicken is Nick's favorite.
Well, then I'm sure you'll ruin plenty of it for him once you're married. Elizabeth! Are you sure Nicholas is right for you? When you were looking for a new husband, did you consider all the possibilities?
I was not looking for a new husband. I was taking care of Jake and myself just fine without one. I was!
Then why are you marrying him?
Because I love him!
Well, there are far better reasons to marry than love. Please let Winifred do that.
So, Mom, Joanna, is Santa going to bring you something special this year? What about Jake? 4 more days to Christmas.
My grandson's old enough to know that his mother and I buy his Christmas presents. And I hope that no one's going to fill that little mind of his with childish stories about Santa Claus and reindeer on the North Pole. I'll get it, Winifred. Mark! Oh, what a surprise. You'll never guess who got here yesterday. Elizabeth?
Look who just happened to drop by.
Mark.
Oh. Mistletoe, don't you love Christmas?
Mark, this is my fiance.
Nick.
I know that.
So, this is the second guy who managed to steal you from me.
Well, I don't think he had me in the first place.
Unfortunately true.
Mark and Elizabeth grew up together. Sit down, dear. So, tell us what you've been doing. I understand that your business is going very well. Didn't I read in the paper the other day that some of your research people came out with a brilliant new way to seal plastic food containers and that your stock tripled overnight?
Well, that's just a bonus, really. Knowing that I'm making the world a more secure place from food poisoning is the real reward.
Of course. And your papa must be so proud.
Yes, I like to think I am living up to my family's proud heritage. But hey, this isn't about me. This is about Lizzie and Nickel. I hope you appreciate what a great gal you have here, Nickel. Because if he doesn't, I know where to find someone who does.
Oh, he appreciates me, all right. And I appreciate him.
But how did you do it? Nickel, how did you manage to sweep this girl off her feet?
All he had to do is be himself.
What on earth is that?
That's the north...
warehouse.
Warehouse. My northern warehouse. Hello? Candy canes. Excuse me. Yeah. Well, just do what my mom did.
He distributes candy canes?
With his mother, apparently.
No, yes. It would take too long to explain.
Well, whatever it is, just do it the way my mom did. Because, Ernest, I don't know about that stuff. That'd be Beth's department. She'll get to it right after we get married on Christmas Eve.
What's my department?
Let me call you back. Which one of these do you think we should use to wrap something red in?
Oh, I don't know anything about the little touches.
Yes, you do, honey.
No, I don't. Didn't you hear Mother? You ask her.
But I'm asking you, sweetheart.
Well, I don't know. Maybe this one.
Ooh, good choice.
Everything okay?
Yeah, he just had a couple problems at the factory.
I thought it was a warehouse.
It is.
It's a combo. Warehouse, factory. I gotta actually straighten out some problems at the warehouse factory. You gonna be okay?
Yes, I'll be fine.
Okay. I won't be long. I'll be back soon.
There's a warehouse here in town.
No. It's, he takes a helicopter from the airport. He does things like that.
Can I say goodnight to Nick?
Afraid you can't, kiddo. He got an emergency call from the North Pole and had to head up there. But he'll be here tomorrow, and you can tell him then, okay? I hope.
You being good?
Yes, Mom. Grandpa read me a story.
You like having a grandpa, don't you?
Yep.
Well, go to sleep, Jakey. I love you.
I love you more.
I love you more. Good night. What did Nick say? Follow the Big Dipper. What points to the North Star, and that's directly above where we live.
Man, sounds like a fruitcake.
Nick's not crazy.
Hey, it's the holiday season. Fruitcake's good.
It's getting cold out here.
Just give me a moment. That's the first chance we had to be alone together all evening.
Well, I didn't know we had anything to be alone about.
Is that any way to speak to the man you were first engaged to?
That was kindergarten. Hardly counts.
Well, I will have you know that I've been saving myself for you ever since.
You've been married. Twice.
Didn't take. Seriously, Lizzie, at least you know me. Now, what do you really know about this Nick guy? Think about how vague his answers were in there tonight. His family distributes things. I mean, it just seems like some kind of fly-by-night operation to me.
Well, that's one way to put it. Look, you don't know anything about Nick. Please trust me that I do. Let's go inside. I'm sure my mother had Winnie bake you a cake this afternoon. She certainly knew you were coming.
What's this?
It's the no letter list. Just because a child doesn't know your address or has parents that are unbelievers doesn't mean they don't get a present. You have to pick one for them.
What did my dad do?
First year, your great-great-great-granddad was Santa. He gave all the boys toy soldiers and all the girls dolls.
Okay, let's do that.
No, no Christmas spirit. That's why your great-great-great-grandmom took over. Ever since then, all the Mrs. Clauses have picked out a present that suited each individual child perfectly. Except for this year.
So this is a Mrs. Claus job. I knew I should have gotten married in January. Are you sure I just can't sneak this to Beth?
She's not a Mrs. Claus yet. She wouldn't have the North Pole magic to help her.
Oh, Ernest.
Oh, Nicholas isn't eating breakfast with you, I see.
He's not back yet.
Is he going to make a habit of doing this? Disappearing in the middle of dinner and staying out all night?
All night, that's where I've been.
Oh.
I'm doing everything I'm supposed to do and everything Mrs. Claus is supposed to do.
Well, I thought there wasn't much for me to do. I thought my job was helping you.
Well, so did I. But the nearer it gets to Christmas, the more I realize how much my mom did. Do you know that I have to pick presents for every kid that hadn't sent a letter? Do you know how hard it is to choose presents for someone I've met? Try doing it thousands of times. Then there's all the wrapping paper and the bows and the ribbons and all the little touches that make Christmas Christmas. I never realized how much she did. Do you know what I was doing last night? I was baking the elves' cookies.
Elves' cookies?
Yes, well, Santa Claus gets cookies and milk from the children, and the elves get cookies and milk from Santa. It didn't dawn on me that someone had to bake them.
Mrs. Claus.
Right, Mrs. Claus. Meanwhile, you were here and I was there and...
I can't bake cookies.
Well, neither can I. You know, I was in the kitchen half the night, and they're as hard as hockey pucks. Two of the elves broke their teeth. Now we're short-staffed in the workshop.
You understand, I can't bake cookies.
Ernest.
It's so big. I thought I was in your bedroom.
What are you doing here?
I checked out Beth's family in the registry. I should have done it a year ago, but I was being optimistic. Do you have any idea how much of an unbeliever Beth's mother is?
On a scale of 1 to 10? 4? 5?
Try a 10.
11.
Oh, dear.
It may be better if we don't tell her.
Don't let her see you yet.
Have we? Elizabeth, don't you feed this child. Winifred, take this child in the kitchen and get him something to eat. Go with Winifred.
You must be Joanna. Glad to meet you.
I'm Virginia. Oh.
You have a beautiful home here.
Well, thank you.
You know, it's not very Christmassy. We've got to do something about that.
Did you have a nice flight?
You know, I could get to like those airplane things, only they're a lot slower than the...
The Concorde. But very comfortable, don't you think?
So you have been down this way before?
Oh, my, yes. Only last year, on the last...
Sir, you've been traveling a long time. Mr. Claus, perhaps you'd like...
And you probably would like to freshen up.
Oh!
I'll show you to your room.
Where's the fire?
My room. Down on the left.
What a nice room.
My mother doesn't know.
Doesn't know what?
That Nicholas is Santa Claus.
Well, we'll have to go tell her.
When are you going to tell her?
You can't lie.
She doesn't have to lie.
Ernest?
I'll go get the bags.
I just don't have to tell her the truth.
Guess what her mother is on the unbeliever scale?
4?
5?
And 11.
Gee, holds it there.
And who are you? We haven't been introduced.
I'm Ernest.
Ernest? Ernest what?
Just Ernest.
Ah, you're their valet.
Ernest is Nick's CEO.
And how do you do, Ernest?
Lying?
I'm not lying.
CEO?
Chief Elf Officer. Oh, hi, Winnie. This is Ernest.
Oh, nice to meet you.
He's Nick's chief EO.
Ah.
John.
Hello? Yeah. It's for you.
Hello. Yeah, I'll ask him. So what are we giving with the tangerines this year? Candies, candy canes, or maple syrup?
Maple syrup. Can't give the children too much sugar.
All three. It's Christmas, for goodness sakes. What do I know? I'm no good with all the little touches.
I'll get back to you.
Mother, I was hoping that I could wear the dress that you and Daddy were married in.
I don't know where it is. I wore my mother's wedding dress. Nicholas and I were married in a snowbank with just some reindeer and our closest friends as witnesses.
A hippie wedding. How quaint.
Sounds beautiful.
Well, I was tall and slender when I married your father. My dress would never fit you. Suck in your stomach.
Do you know what I do when I think I need to diet?
Eat healthy, eat less?
Oh, heck no! I fix Nicholas and me up a great big meal of our favorite foods. Puts the diet clean out of my mind.
Oh, we're going to have to loosen it up back there, too. All right, I guess that's as good as it's going to get in the time we've got.
Everybody, it's me.
Stop! Close your eyes. Turn around. Did you see her?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Oh.
What happens if he does?
Well, it's bad luck for the groom to see the bride's dress before the wedding. Did you see her?
Maybe. I'm not sure.
We've got to get a different dress.
That is utter nonsense. You don't believe in that superstitious claptrap, do you? Besides, we don't have time to get another dress.
Used to, when I got one of those, it came with milk and cookies.
Elizabeth, that dress makes you look so much slimmer. I knew it would when I saw it in the store.
Mm. Thank you, Mother.
So, shall everybody please sit down? Oh, my dear. Who set the table? Winifred, you may serve us now. Thank you. So, Nicholas.
Yes?
Your son began to tell us last night a little bit about the business that you're in before he was rudely interrupted. Exactly what is it that you do?
Well, my family...
The Clauses own a family-run organization that stretches back for generations, catering almost exclusively to children.
Oh, go on.
By distributing toys, clothing, multimedia devices that appeal to an age group from toddlers to teens.
Go on.
Plus, we service countries on every continent.
Thank you.
Although we do have manufacturing facilities, we are chiefly known for our distribution of many other companies' fine products.
Quit while you're ahead.
We have, in recent years, begun to receive requests through the World Wide Web, although the main body of our consumers prefers to correspond through traditional postal services. We do, however, offer overnight delivery that is second to none.
Well, that sounds simple enough.
Is Ernest?
The stocking department.
Stocking department? Oh, that's for children who don't have any...
Stockings or socks. It's part of the family's charity work. Nicholas.
Excuse me.
Is he going to be gone all night?
Oh, I hope not. The poor boy, he's been working so hard. He really does need help. But, I think he'll be getting some soon.
You have to go.
No, you have to go.
I can't go. I went in the middle of dinner last night.
All right, I'll go. But if anything goes wrong here, on your head be it.
All right, I'll go. But if anything goes wrong up there, on your head be it.
Nick must have forgot something. Mark.
Lizzie.
Did you
see Nick out here a second ago?
No.
Oh, Lizzie.
Good. Lizzie.
Yes.
You have to think about this now. In a couple of days, it'll be too late. What can this Nickel character offer you that I can't?
Nicholas,
whatever. I mean, where are you going to live? Have you even seen this factory or warehouse or whatever it is? I mean, do you even know it exists?
You sure that he wasn't out here just a second ago?
Yes, I'm sure. Lizzie.
Yeah.
Marry me instead of him. And I will keep you in the manner to which you are accustomed. And Jake, it'll be first class for both of you all the way. Christmas 24/7, 365. What do you say? No. Will you marry? See? You're thinking about it. You're tempted. Just say yes. You'll make me happy. You'll make your mother happy. And I will make you and Jake happy.
Mark, thank you for the very flattering offer. But I'm still taking Nick's Christmas 24/7, 365. Night, Mark. Thank you.
Down to the chimney with lots of toys, all for the little ones' Christmas joys. Ho, 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 who wouldn't go? Ho, 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 who wouldn't go? Oh, up on the housetop, click, click, click. Down through the chimney comes good Saint Nick.
You be okay in here without me?
I'll be fine, Mom.
I'll be right next door if you need me.
3 days, Nick will be married at last.
You'll have a dad again and a new family.
I already have a new family. The wedding's just crossing the T's and dotting the I's.
Who said that?
Grandpa. I think he'll be a great Mrs. Claus. Just know it.
I hope so. I love you.
I love you more.
I love you more.
Ho, 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 who wouldn't go? Ho, ho, ho.
Right. I don't do cookies.
Ernest, your watch.
Is everything okay?
You bet. Lucky we have a long night to the North Pole. We'd never be able to get it all done. Hey, Ernest.
I'm still looking for something special for Beth. If you come across
anything. I'll let you know.
May I join you?
Oh, good morning, my dear. Please do.
Nick's back. He's sleeping.
Good. It's on the back of the pantry door.
What?
The recipe for Mrs. Claus cookies. It's on the pantry door in the kitchen at the North Pole. Now, Nick can't see it because he's not a Mrs. Claus, but you will.
Well, it's not going to help. Even when I follow a recipe to the T, it doesn't turn out.
But you're not there yet. Wait till you bake with North Pole magic.
I'm just not a Christmassy person. 1 year ago, I was just like my mother, an unbeliever. I just don't know anything about the Christmas spirit.
But Beth, none of us did. We didn't grow up there. We were used to this, the real world. I mean, what did we know about the North Pole? Do you know what my Nick's mom told me that her Nick's mom told her? Imagine every child is your child. It works. You'll do fine. Just trust yourself.
Well, all your friends seem to have bought the same Christmas cards this year. There must have been a special at the club.
Oh, don't be facetious, Elizabeth. They're RSVPs.
RSVPs for what?
To your wedding, darling.
Exactly how many people did you ask?
Only 150. You said you wanted to keep it small.
I said a dozen or less.
Oh, I knew you didn't mean that. Nobody wants a dozen guests at their wedding. People will think you have something to be ashamed of.
It's supposed to be only friends and family.
It is only family and friends.
Well, then that's it. We're going to elope.
No, I forbid it. You did that the last time with poor Robert, and it was a disaster.
No, it wasn't. It was fun. It was fast. It was affordable.
That's not a wedding. That's a used car. And why all the urgency? I still don't understand what the rush is all about. Why couldn't you have waited until the new year and have a proper wedding?
Because we have to get married before Christmas Eve.
Why?
Because, Mother... Nick has to go away on a business trip, and we want to get married before he goes.
Another business trip? Is this what your marriage is going to be like? Him vanishing off like this all the time?
It's not our wedding, it's hers!
Oh, good morning, honey.
You know what we're eating at the reception? Wrong! Not the roasted chicken that we asked for, but pheasant or salmon. Do you know what I'm wearing? Not the dress that she married my daddy in, but some brand new dress from a Barbie catalog. Do you know who's coming to this wedding? Not the 12 people that we asked, but 150 of her closest friends. She might as well stand at the door at the club and just pass out tickets. This is not our wedding.
Sweetheart, your mother is giving us the best wedding she can imagine. And she can't imagine us wanting it any other way.
I can't believe I let myself get talked into this. You don't do things with my mother. She does it her way, and I tag along and say thank you. Nothing is how we planned it.
Is someone else getting married?
No.
And at the end of this, will we be married?
Yes.
And will we be spending our very first family Christmas up at the North Pole?
Yes.
Arguing about it change anything? In 2 days, you'll be Mrs. Claus. That's all that counts.
What's that behind your ear?
Magic? I love when you do that.
No, that's not magic. That's a trick. They're not the same thing. Tricks aren't real. Magic is.
Will I learn how to do magic?
Oh, yes.
Jacob, Winnie needs to see you in the kitchen. She needs help with something.
Right now?
Yes, now. Now, it is fine for you to teach him conjuring tricks in order to amuse people, but please do not make him believe it is any more than that.
Oh, I didn't. I told him tricks are tricks and magic is magic.
But that's exactly what I mean.
Then we agree. Oh, I think I hear Mrs. Claus calling me. Excuse me.
Morning, Beth.
Hi, Grandpa.
Beth! I think he's going senile.
What did he say?
He said that magic is real.
Oh, is that all? Mother, the clauses are a little bit nutball. That's what I like about them.
Elizabeth!
What, Mother?
Is this tree taller than it was this morning?
I don't know. Did you buy a new one?
No, it's the same tree.
Maybe it grew. Trees do that.
Not like this, they don't.
Well, how else are you going to explain it then? Hey, Winnie. Oh, Ernest, there you are. Nick went back, right?
He'll be back in time for the party.
Do you have a minute? What happens? Go ahead and sit down. Go ahead, Nick. What happens if Mrs. Claus can't do magic?
Never happens. There's something in the North Pole that brings out the magic in all of them. I think it's in the Northern Lights.
But what if she doesn't have any magic in her to begin with?
Why would Santa Claus pick a Mrs. Claus if he didn't have any magic in her?
I don't know. Just what if he did?
I remember Nicholas's great-great-grandmother. As you know, I'm the eternal optimist, but even I thought that her Santa had made a terrible mistake. I couldn't see an ounce of magic in her. But she proved us wrong. She didn't even have to touch the scrolls. All she had to do was mention the child's name once, and in a flash, she knew exactly what he wanted and what paper to wrap it in so that it matched his stockings. Talk about the little touches. Some of the elves say that she was the best Mrs. Claus ever. Oh, and her cookies. I can still taste them. Excuse me. This is Ernest. Yes. Yes, I'm coming now. I'll bring you right back.
Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, la la la.
Just what are you up to?
Nothing.
Well, don't let Mother see you doing it, okay?
Doing what? Beth, I've been looking for the perfect present for you. I just haven't been able to find it yet.
All I want for Christmas is a kiss from you right now.
Mom, I'm starving.
You go get ready, and I'll get him something from the kitchen.
Okay.
Come on, pal. Let's get you something to eat.
Elizabeth, I just picked up a new dress for you at Anita's boutique. Winifred put it in your closet.
Oh, I already have a dress for tonight. Oh,
but you want to look your best, don't you?
Winnie, we're starving. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, you'll have to wait till the bar to start. There'll be lots of food there.
Ooh, are these chocolate?
Don't touch.
Winnie, may I see you for a moment, please?
Don't you boys dare touch anything.
Us? Us? Did you think that, Winnie? Oh, great. This is a very interesting contraption. I wonder what this does. Well, I would suppose you would have to aim it in the correct direction.
Party to present you to all of Elizabeth's friends, and you go crazy with a cream whipper. I mean, I expect this of Jacob. He's just a child, but you're supposed to be a grown-up. Clean this mess up now. Winifred? Who put up all these decorations?
Well, I have no idea, Mrs. Hardcastle. Oh, my. Doesn't that tree look lovely? I had no idea we had all these ornaments.
Firing squad?
They can't be that bad.
Oh, you're so good. Mark 2 o'clock. Don't look. Don't look. You looked.
Lizzie, you look ravishing.
Thank you.
No.
Mark, I know how much it means to Beth that you're here.
Welcome.
Shall we?
Oh, my, what a party.
Elizabeth, it's so good to see you.
Mr. Montgomery.
Good to see you, Elizabeth. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
And this must be Nicholas.
Nick, this is Mark's parents.
Oh, congratulations, Nicholas. You're a very lucky young man.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Oh, what a lovely party, Joanna.
Joanna, aren't you going to introduce us?
Oh, yes, this is Douglas Montgomery, Abigail Montgomery. This is Nicholas Sr., Virginia Claus. They're Nicholas's parents.
Oh. Glad to meet you, Douglas. Wait a minute. Douglas Montgomery, Christmas 1947, you got a red radio flyer wagon.
How on earth would you know that?
Well, I bet because that was so popular when you and Grandpa Claus were young. You need to eat because you haven't eaten. Excuse us. We're going to run back here.
Joanna.
Hey.
What are you doing here alone?
I'm just thinking.
About?
You? I'm wondering why you would choose me when you could have any girl in the world. Better at cooking, better at Christmas, better at everything.
You know what? You are the dumbest smart girl I know. I've searched the world and I chose you. Honey, I just look at you and I melt. No one else does that. I see you, honey, and I can think of doing only one thing.
Nick, this is serious.
So am I.
This isn't me. I don't dress like this.
You look beautiful. Look, your mother has all these people for me to meet. These are friends of your mother's. Some of them have known you since you were a child.
No, you're right. It's just that...
What?
They seem to value all the things that don't matter.
Well, maybe that's because they live in the real world. It's easy to act and think the right things when you live in an ivory snow cone called the North Pole. Honey.
Ah, Lizzie Nichol, there you are. It's time to make a toast to the happy couple.
You have to join the party.
Of course.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have a moment, please? Elizabeth's mother has asked me to say a few words. as most of you know, Lizzie and I have known each other our whole lives. She was my first partner in dance class. Sorry about that broken toe. She was my first crush, my first kiss. I was not fortunate enough to claim her as my wife. However, I truly wish her all the happiness in the world with the man who was lucky enough to have captured her heart. Ladies and gentlemen, I charge you, raise your glasses to Elizabeth and Nick. May they live happily ever after.
Here, 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 here. Congratulations. Excuse me. Excuse me. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Mark. Oh, that was beautiful. That was lovely. Thank you so...
Don't you dare.
I'm sorry, Joanna. It's an emergency.
Nicholas, you cannot leave your own engagement party. I forbid it.
Go. Do what you have to do.
Oh. Dad, Mom.
Yeah.
You'll help hold down the fort with Beth. Let's go. I apologize, Mark.
Nicholas.
I'm so sorry, everyone. I'm so sorry. I apologize. Thank you. Thank you, Dad.
Excuse me. No, down the front.
There was a fire. Something electrical. Nobody's fault, but the entire house burned down. The family lost everything.
Was anyone hurt?
The children's mother and father had some burns, but they'll be okay, thank goodness. The children weren't injured.
Oh, okay. So, we need a new present for each and every one of them.
And they have to be in stock, or we have to make them quickly.
What are their names? Jasper Frost. Jasper Frost. You've lost all your toys. You want to start over. Ooh! A box of blocks and a red rocket wagon. Some things never change.
And his sister.
Poppy Frost. Poppy Frost. Poppy Frost. I don't know. I can't do this.
You have to try.
I know who'll know.
Nicholas, that is not a good idea.
It's just one time. It'll be good for her.
Nicholas, Santa, sir.
What kind of nincompoop dresses up like Santa Claus so that I am the laughingstock of all of my friends?
Mother, they can hear me.
I don't care if they hear me.
What Nick's parents wear is not important.
You, young lady, are marrying some sort of twisted, lower-class, uncouth...
Nick's parents have plenty of couth.
They do not fit into our world.
I'm more worried about fitting in theirs.
Oh, please do not tell me that you'll be moving into a trailer park.
Oh, Mother, I can promise you, Jake and I will not be living there.
Beth, I'm sorry.
Is everything okay?
It will be. I need your help.
What's the matter?
Her name is Poppy Frost.
No, Nick, I can't do this. I'm not ready yet.
Yes, you can. I know you can. You just have to believe in yourself as much as I believe in you. Come on. Chance. Poppy Frost. Say it. Poppy Frost. Poppy Frost. Poppy Frost.
Poppy Frost. Frost.
Poppy Frost. Poppy Frost. Poppy Frost. Now, what does Poppy Frost want for Christmas after she's lost everything?
Poppy Frost. I don't know. Dollhouse and a dolly. No, wait. She's a tomboy. She wants a basketball and a bike. I don't know. I can't do this. How am I supposed to imagine what a child I've never even heard of even looks like, much less what she wants for Christmas to start her life over again?
Oh, Beth.
Mother, you are so wrong about Nick's parents. They are the greatest people you will ever meet.
Don't be ridiculous. They're just nothing
Santa but... Claus and his wife, Mrs. Claus. Yes, that's right. This is the real Santa Claus. Why do you think they wear red all the time? Why else would he have that beard? Grandpa Claus isn't pretending. That's who he is, or was. Nick is now.
You are deranged. They have brainwashed you.
They did nothing of the sort. Nick is Santa Claus. And I was going to be Mrs. Claus. Only I'm not up to it. I never managed to do Christmas for my own son, much less the whole world. Nick, I'm so sorry. I love you so much. But I'm the wrong person. I'm not good enough to be Mrs. Claus. I just don't know how.
Beth, you learned.
No, I've tried. And every time I fail, I'm not good at this. Nick, there's no magic in me. None. Take it.
Beth, please don't. I don't want it, Beth. I can't take that.
And yes, Mother, we're nothing like these people. They are far, far better than us. Come on, Jake. We're leaving.
No.
We don't belong here.
Where are we going?
Home. We're going to rescue our house from the realtors. It's the one place we do belong.
You better go with her, Jake.
You need to stop her.
Sorry, Nicholas, but Christmas can't be Christmas without a Mrs. Claus.
Oh, my goodness. My.
Never thought I'd live to see the day.
I'm sorry, Ernest.
In all my years, I never saw a Santa ever organize a first Christmas as well as you.
Thank you, Ernest.
How about a round of golf before lunch?
I'm sorry, my dear. I just don't feel like it.
Neither do I.
I have to agree with you, Bob. I don't think that there's ever been a Christmas Eve like this. All around the world, it's really beginning to feel a lot not like Christmas. And no one seems to know exactly what it is, but my sources tell me it has something to do with problems up at the North Pole.
I'll tell you what happened. There's just no Christmas spirit. It's all evaporated. That's what happened. For the first time ever, Christmas Eve and Christmas Day are going to be just work days. Just like any other day. All over the country, people are canceling their travel plans, returning their presents to stores, postponing their parties, and just going to work.
I just wanted to show Beth how perfect she is, that she didn't need North Pole magic. That she could have known what that little girl wanted just because of who she is. How can I be so stupid?
You are not to know, sir.
There's not going to be Christmas for anyone. Not for Beth. Not for Jake. Not for the whole world. Not for that little girl. It's all canceled.
Oh. Oh, ho, ho, holy reindeer! Why did I think of this before?
Santa!
What I'm gonna miss most is having family.
We'll just have to be our own family. Like we were before any of this started.
But we'll still believe in Santa?
Yes, Jakey. We'll always believe in Santa.
Are you Beth?
Yeah.
I'm Poppy. A man gave me this bike and this ball. He said that even though no one's having a real Christmas, he still wanted me to have them. And then I opened the card, and it said it was from you. So I rode down here to say thank you. I don't know how you knew what I wanted, but whatever. Thank you.
No problem. You're welcome.
Gotta go. Bye.
Merry Christmas.
See, you knew what she wanted. Just like you knew which paper and bows went together. The big stuff and the little touches. You knew it all.
But I couldn't bake the Mrs. Claus cookies.
You can't bake anything. But you could have hit the North Pole. You would have been a great Mrs. Claus.
Maybe. But I think it's kind of late to find that out now. I hardly think Nick will take me back after I've wrecked Christmas. Hey, anyway, there's no sense in crying over spilt milk, is there? Come on, we'll put the stuff inside, and then we'll walk across the road to Joni's, and then we'll call the movers and get them to bring our stuff back.
Can you ever forgive me?
Can you forgive me?
It's all my fault.
It's all my fault. I should have trusted you. I should have trusted myself.
Beth, I love you. I will always love you.
I will always love you.
Beth, will you marry me?
Of course I will, my darling.
Now that that's settled, we have a schedule to keep.
What schedule? We can't get married until after the new year. I mean, we can't even get a rent-a-judge now. No one's available.
Yes, they are. Everyone's canceled their Christmas plans, remember? Which means that the caterers we always wanted are available again.
Roasted chicken.
And the florists that we always wanted are available again. And even Reverend Moran is available now.
Father Joe.
Good to see you, my dear. Cloud must have a silver lining.
You see, we can have a small, romantic, beautiful wedding that we always dreamed of.
We heard a rumor that somebody's getting married.
It's true, Dad.
Grandma, Grandpa.
How are you?
So happy to be here.
Joni, isn't it wonderful?
I missed your last wedding. May I please come to this one?
Do you believe in Santa Claus?
Oh, yes, Jake, I do. Especially after Santa landed on my roof with 8 reindeer and invited me here.
Then you can come.
Oh, I brought you this. It's the dress I married your daddy in. I'm sure we need to pin it up just a little, but otherwise, it'll fit you beautifully. Oh, sweetheart, I have done so many foolish things. Can you ever forgive me?
Of course I can, Mama.
Nick, dear, thank you. I am sure my daughter will make a wonderful Mrs. Claus.
People, we have a schedule to keep.
I'm going to go easy.
Good luck,
Dad.
Beth, Mrs. Claus and me, well, we never had a daughter, even though we always hoped that we would. So I was wondering if you would do me the honor of permitting me to walk you down the aisle.
The honor would be all mine.
Here today.
We don't have time for a full service. Could you skip ahead a bit?
Right here. Do you, Nicholas, take Beth to be your wife, promising to be true to her in good times and in bad, in sickness and health, and that you will love and honor her all the days of your life? Do you, Beth, take Nicholas to be your husband, promising to be true to him in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, and that you will love and honor him all the days of your life?
I do.
Then I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Starting in under 4 hours. We're not ready yet.
Don't worry, Ernest. We will be.
Now that we have our Mrs. Claus. Jake, come up here. Oh, yeah.
My dad's Santa Claus.